berhasil membuat kue. Hai kids, kalian tahu nggak kalau Kande hari ini lulus dari baking course? Kande sangat senang sekali. Dan Kande akan merayakannya dengan kue yang enak buatan Kande ini. Tapi Kande harus menunggu karena kuenya pasti masih panas. Kita akan merayakannya, tapi harus tunggu kue ini dingin dahulu ya. Untuk itu mari kita sabar menunggu. Sabar adalah menunggu sampai sesuatu yang kita inginkan terjadi. Menunggu sangat membosankan, kids. Aku ada ide. Bagaimana jika kita mendengarkan cerita tentang satu bangsa yang merayakan sesuatu setelah mereka menunggu kedatangan Tuhan Yesus ke kota mereka yang begitu lama. Tapi sebelum itu kita akan memuji Tuhan dulu ya. Let's praise Him!
Hai kids, ada sukacita hari ini? Yes, pasti ya. Ayo semuanya bangkit berdiri yuk. Karena kita mau kasih yang terbaik buat Tuhan kita ketika kita menyembah Tuhan. Come on, yay! Woo! Ayo semuanya tepuk tangan kayak gini, come on. Yay! Wah! Woo! Ikutin gerakan kakak gue. Bukan kuat dan gagahku, tapi oleh Roh-Mu ku berdiri dan bernyanyi. Tinggikan nama-Mu, keselamatanku, Kau pembebasku, Kau sukacitaku. Terbang tinggi untuk kasih setiamu, hormat dan semaku ku kasih Kau Yesusku. Dengan hidupku selalu bersyukur, selalu bersyukur, takkan terukur. Sukacita, sukacitaku, karenamu semuanya lompat, come on. Tuhan ku baik, Tuhan ku baik, samanya ku kan menari. Terbang tinggi, terbang tinggi. Keep sex singing. Ku angkat dulu hidupku, ku angkat tangan pujimu, karenamu, karenamu ku berjanji. Ku takkan berhenti. Ayo, tepuk tangan sama-sama, come on. Woo! Yeah! Tuhan sumber suka cita kita, yeah! One, two, one, two, three, say, ah! Tuhan ku baik, Tuhan ku baik. Ku kan menari, ku kan menari. Ah, Terbang tinggi, terbang tinggi. Sit. Buat Tuhan kita, come on kids, yeah! Woo! Let's go!
Woo! Kids, hari ini kita akan belajar tentang satu bangsa yang menunggu kedatangan Yesus ke kota mereka. Nah, ketika kita menunggu, kita juga harus sambil memuliakan Tuhan loh. Bangsa ini memuliakan Tuhan ketika dia datang dengan menaruh pakaian mereka sebagai alas di tanah. Ternyata kita juga bisa memuliakan Tuhan dengan harta kita. Kita lihat ayatnya di Amsal 3 ayat 9 sampai 10a. Muliakanlah Tuhan dengan hartamu dan dengan hasil pertama dari segala penghasilanmu. Maka lumbungmu akan diisi penuh sampai berlimpah-limpah. Ayat tadi mengatakan kita bisa memuliakan Tuhan dengan harta kita, yaitu dengan memberikan persembahan kita dengan sukacita. Memberi dengan sukacita itu artinya kita merayakan kebaikannya saat menunggu. Kalian siap memberi? Mari kita berdoa. Tuhan, terima kasih atas kasih karuniamu. Kalau sebentar kami akan memberi untuk merayakan kebaikanmu. Terima kasih Tuhan, di dalam namamu kami berdoa. Amin. Selamat memberi, kids.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history. Stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Matthew, chapter 21, verses 1 through 11.
For hundreds of years, God's people had been waiting on a savior for rescue. Every year at Passover, they celebrated how God had freed them from slavery in Egypt, and they looked forward to how one day God would rescue them again.
Lord, save us!
The city of Jerusalem was filled to overflowing for Passover, and news of anything unusual spread quick as flame.
They say Jesus is coming into the city.
That teacher fella?
He made somebody alive again, even though they were dead.
Lazarus? Well, if you believe that sort of thing.
My cousin Sarah saw it with her own eyes.
Excitement and tensions ran high in the city, and as the people prepared to celebrate, the religious leaders hatched their own plans.
This Jesus is trouble. He says too much.
He does too much.
Then we'll have to do something about that, won't we?
A short distance away near the town of Bethany, Jesus was indeed preparing to make his way to Jerusalem. He called two of his disciples, maybe Peter and John.
Go into the village. As soon as you get there, you will find a donkey tied up. Her colt will be with her. Untie them and bring them to me.
Consider it done.
But wait, we can't just take someone's donkey.
If anyone says anything to you, say that the Lord needs them. The owner will send them right away.
Okay. Good.
The two disciples hurried into the village.
Jesus didn't say where to look, so.
Steady there.
The two disciples quickly untied the donkey and her colt.
Hey!
Hello?
What are you doing? Why are you untying my donkeys?
It's like this.
The Lord needs them.
Oh!
Okay, then.
The disciples led the colt and its mother back to Jesus. They even draped their coats on the backs of the donkeys.
There. Nice and comfy.
Sort of.
So Jesus climbed onto the back of the colt, and his friends followed close behind as they started on their way down the dusty road towards the city. Though his friends didn't realize it till later, Jesus was fulfilling the words of the prophet Zechariah from hundreds of years before.
Say to the city of Zion, see, your king comes to you. He is gentle and riding on a donkey.
The road was crowded with travelers making their way to Jerusalem. Other people spilled out of the city when they heard that Jesus was on the way.
Praise God! Have you heard what this man has done?
People actually began to take off their coats and throw them on the road before Jesus. They tore palm branches from the trees and waved them on high.
Hosanna!
Blessed is the one who comes in the
some of the religious leaders had joined the crowd to discover what was going on.
This whole thing is preposterous.
Out of control.
So tell him to stop.
Who, me?
Hosanna! Hosanna! Hosanna!
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Who comes in the name of the Lord.
Teacher. Teacher.
As the donkey carried him slowly forward, Jesus turned to look at the religious leaders. They glared back.
Teacher, tell your followers to stop this instant.
Jesus took in the joyful crowds. He looked ahead at the walled city of Jerusalem, sprouting up from the rocky hillsides. Then he looked back at the religious leaders.
I tell you, if they keep quiet, the stones will cry out.
As Jesus rode on, the religious leaders fell back, grumbling to each other.
This isn't getting us anywhere.
Look how the whole world is following him.
So even though these religious leaders had studied and waited their whole lives for a savior, they didn't recognize Jesus when he came. But still, the people continued to cheer and to follow Jesus into the city.
Cerita hari ini sangat luar biasa ya. Dari cerita Palm Sunday tadi, kita bisa belajar bahwa kita bisa merayakan sesuatu bahkan di saat kita sedang menunggu. Menunggu sangat membosankan dan sangat sulit, membuang banyak waktu. Kita akan bisa merayakan segala sesuatu dan bersuka cita saat kita menunggu bersama Tuhan Yesus. Jadi, hal yang perlu diingat hari ini adalah you can celebrate even when you're waiting. Wow, kuenya sudah dingin dan kita bisa memakannya sekarang. Mari kita rayakan kelulusan Kande. Happy Sunday, kids. See you next week.